everybody, it's Jeff Davis, episode 3. Today we talk about inviting crazy Uncle Earl to the volleyball match. And he goes nuts in the stands, baby! We talk about post-game analysis in the car, on the way home, and the discussions that you have with your athlete. And we talk about the Rams, baby! Get ready for the show. Hubba hubba. Let's get the show underway. Anna, take it away.
Sarah writes, I want to invite my daughter's uncle to watch a tournament, but sometimes he's a bit emotional and takes this sports stuff really seriously. She's afraid his yelling might be embarrassing. Would it be better if he did not come? Do you guys video your games so that he can watch them later? I want to be supportive, but I certainly don't want to cause her harm.
Everybody knows him. Everybody has one. He comes to Thanksgiving dinner and goes nuts. He comes to Christmas dinner and he goes nuts again. We do want Uncle Earl at the volleyball tournament. But what's going to happen is little Susie on the stands, she's going to miss a call. The line judge, she's going to miss a call. We want Uncle Earl to be prepared for that. Our goal is not to win every game, although we'd love to win every match. But we're doing a lot more than winning on the court. We're training kids and we're giving them the tools that they can use to effectively handle adversity when they experience it. And one of those variables that they use is how we respond to adversity. So we work really, really hard at making sure that we have, and no matter what we say, we have respect for the players that are trying to learn how to ref a game and make decisions, the players across the bench, that whether or not they have any respect for us, we're gonna have it for them. And we're trying to teach them how to be great citizens. And so I would advise you, I would say that if you're gonna invite Uncle Earl to Susie's match or Sally's match or your beautiful daughter's match, we wanna make sure that you either sit next to him or that he understands that the mission is dual here. It's to win, but it's to do it in a way that honors the game, honors the team on the other side of the bench, and honors the club, okay? Bring him, I wanna see him. And make sure you introduce me to Uncle Earl. Anna, next question.
Charlie writes, my kid seems to get frustrated when I try to help her understand on the way home what she did wrong and needs to work on after a match. Don't you guys teach that giving immediate feedback is critical to the learning process and overall success of an athlete?
Everybody wants to do it. Everybody wants to talk about the game to its detail. Psychologists, sports psychologists have given us top 5 reasons why kids leave sports, and one of them is a constant barrage of talking about the infinite details of what coulda, shoulda, woulda been in a match on the way home. Kids want to get away from that, break away from that. So I would advise you, on the way home, don't discuss the game at all. Don't discuss the match. Hey, you did a great job. I love seeing you play. I love what you do. I love watching you. You're great. Let's move to the next. Let's go see Uncle Earl. Let's go to the ice cream store. Let's go get some steak. Let's go get some dinner. But try to avoid that conversation on the way home. You'll feel better. Your kids will feel better. And I think what you'll find is that they bounce back from any kind of defeat very, very rapidly. Okay? Got it? All right. Anna, what do we got? Oh, yeah. What? The Rams? Oh, yeah, baby. The Rams. They're gone. What do you think about that? Who's the quarterback? Who was the quarterback of the Rams? Does anybody know who running was? Marshall Faulk still playing? Is it Marshall Faulk? I think so. Bill, you know anything about the Rams, Rector?
Just get
them
out of here.
Oh, man. Oh, gosh, dog. We did so much. We're going to do all these Rams jerseys and Rams gear. I guess I got to sell all my bobbleheads, baby. Hey, thank you all for joining us. See you next time. Go H2.